What happens when your skills suddenly, irreversibly erode and yet you're still baseball's most overpaid player? For Chris Davis, you handle your demise with class and dignity. There's no doubt that Baltimore Orioles first baseman Chris Davis is handling himself the right way. Plenty of players in his position would be defensive or in denial about their decline. Not Davis. After hitting 159 home runs in a four-year span, Baltimore locked Davis up to a seven-year, $161 million contract extension. In the four seasons since he's hit 80, with 38 of those coming in 2016, his first year of the deal. As Eddie Matz of ESPN.com expertly documented, Davis was mercilessly booed by the Baltimore fans on Thursday during its home opener, an 8-4 loss to the New York Yankees. They were fed up and frustrated with a player signed to one of the worst contracts ever for a position player. "I understand the frustration," Davis said. "Nobody's more frustrated than I am. Especially a day like today." Even in the 2016 where he still possessed his power stroke and helped Baltimore make the playoffs, he also helped the O's to the postseason in 2012. Davis led the major leagues with 219 strikeouts in 566 at-bats. In 2017, he struck out 195 times in 456 at-bats, hitting 26 home runs but batting just .215 with a .309 on-base percentage. In 2018, as the Orioles went 47-115, the worst record in the 118-year history of the franchise, Davis truly bottomed out. He hit .168 with a .243 on-base percentage with 16 home runs and just 12 doubles, with 192 strikeouts in just 470 at-bats. After ending 2018 going 0-for-21, Davis is hitless in 17 at-bats to begin the season. His contract is untradeable, yet with Baltimore embarking on what we'll kindly call a rebuilding year, the team has yet to have an issue with trotting Davis out there day after day, with no escape or respite from seeing a once-feared offensive player ceaselessly living with the fact that as a baseball player he is barely a shell of his former self. It's contracts like Davis that give so many teams pause when it comes to big money contracts for players in their 30s. Baseball now rightfully sees contracts like Davis as cautionary tales, and are reluctant to give out those deals to similar sluggers, contributing to the lack of big-time free agency in baseball over the winter. Unless you're Bryce Harper or Manny Machado, the days of mega free agent deals for veteran players are currently a thing of the past. Davis' contract is certainly not the only warning sign teams have seen over the last several years. Josh Hamilton hit just 39 home runs in three seasons after signing a five-year, $125 million contract with the Angels prior to the 2013 season before his career was sadly derailed. Jason Hayward has been an enormous disappointment since he signed an eight-year, $184 million contract before the 2016 season, though he's won two Gold Glove Awards and helped the Cubs to their eternally awaited World Series win. Other superstars in their primes have signed huge money extensions that went horribly wrong, including Miguel Cabrera, Prince Fielder, and Robinson Cano, but they declined steadily over time and suffered either long-term injuries or, in Cano's case, had a lengthy performance-enhancing drug suspension. Cano is still looking to contributing for the Mets after an off-season trade from the Seattle Mariners. For Davis, there was no drug suspension. There was no huge injury to really blame for the 33-year-old being unable to consistently hit at the big league level. Sometimes players just don't have it anymore, and the Orioles are now heavily paying the price. It's yet to be seen whether Baltimore wants to just cut ties with Davis and buy out a contract that runs through the 2023 season, when Davis will be 37, or if they want to hold on to him and see if he recaptures the stroke that once made him one of the sport's toughest hitters to go up against earlier this decade. Davis is undoubtedly handling things the exact right way, but there's no way around the fact that his $161 million contract is one of the worst this game has ever seen.